Okay, let's keep on going to the next step of slope. I wrote down the formula here, right here. Remember, it's change in y over a change in x, rise over run. We're used to this now. But what if I give you a question that has 2 points and I tell you to do this without graphing? Uh-oh, no, it's not. It's easy as pie. Watch what happens. Look at the formula. It says the slope is the rise. Remember, the rises are your y values. So take a difference in the y values. y2, y1, that's your y values. Look at your run. It's a change in the x values, x2 minus x1. What does that mean? Let's clean this up and let's do this. Watch this. Let me show you. Here's 2 points, this one and this one. All right? So what you should do first is label it. Label, 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 label. Let's call this point one. Okay? Let's call this point. Oh, that looks messy here. Wait. Hold a second. There we go. That, we'll call it point two. Okay? So if this is point one, right? This is x1 and y1. If this is point two, this is x2 and y2. Now look at the formula, which is on your formula sheet. So all you have to do is plug in the numbers and it should work. Okay, so here we go. y2 minus y1. y2 is 6 minus y1. y1 is negative 5. So minus a negative 5. Watch out for those minus minus ones. They're going to come back and they're going to bite you. Okay, x2 is 8. x1 is 4. So 8 minus 4. According to the definition, you just subtract them out. Okay, so 6 minus minus makes it plus 5. 8 minus 4 is easy. That's just 4. 6 plus 5 is 11 over 4. There is your slope. And they actually give slope a symbol. They call it M. That's a scripted M. So your slope is 11 over 4. So look back at the definition here. This is right out of your textbook. Slope of the line. Look what they did. They labeled the x1 the y1, the x2 the y2, and there's that wonderful formula that's on your formula sheet. And look what that means. That just means y2 minus y1, x2 minus x1. There's your rise. There's your run. That's how it works. So what if you're given a question now that's a bit of a challenge? Like this one. What if I gave you the slope and I told you, here are two possible points on that line which define this slope. Okay? Notice that one of them here does not have a number. Okay. How do you solve this? Simple. Remember the slope formula. Notice I'm using M now in terms of its proper notation. Slope formula is y2 minus y1, x2 minus x1. Okay, so here we go. First things first. Tell me which one is point one, which one is point two. Here we go. I'm going to say that this is point one. I'm going to say that this is point 2. So that would make this guy here x1, y1. This guy here x2, y2. You got it so far? Okay. So here we go. Your slope is actually 5 over 2, which equals to then this formula. Well, plug in the values. There's y2 at 7. Minus y1, which is, minus 3. x2, which is b, minus x1, which is minus 2. Okay, so we got lots of minus minuses stuff happening here. So let's give ourselves a little bit more room. Here we go. Simplify this a little bit. You have 5 over 2. That's this guy. Nothing changed there. 7 minus a minus 3 is 7 plus 3. B minus a minus 2. B plus 2. Because remember, minus minus means plus. Let's simplify this a little bit more. 5 over 2 equals to 7 plus 3 is 10. over b plus 2. Now, you're probably sitting here going, what do I do next? Simple. What you did in grade 5, cross multiply. 2 times 10 is 20, and 5 times b plus 2. Now, you have a couple of options at this point. You can turn around at this point and distribute the 5. I wouldn't. You know that this is times. Let's just get rid of the 5 right now. Look at that. Algebra tells you that you can use this right now and get rid of the 5s. So 20 divided by 5 is 4, leaving you with b plus 2. Simple. Subtract 2 from both sides, and lo and behold, b equals to a rockin' 2. Now, if b is 2, let's go back to the original numbers then. B is 2. That means this guy right here is 2. So you had an a, which was a minus 2, minus 3. Let's clean that up so we can actually see it. Yeah, it is minus 2, minus 3. We had a b, which now has our new value in it, which is 2, 7. We figured that one out. Let's figure out if the slope is right. Okay, let's see if we can come up with this 5 over 2 value here. Okay, so again, make sure you label first. X1, Y1. X2, Y2. Here we go. Y2 minus Y1 over X2 minus X1. Let's see if this value is right. If it is, we should get this answer back. Okay, here we go. Whew, let's try. Y2 is 7, right there. Minus a minus 3. Beautiful. X2 is 2. That's what we figured out. X1 is a minus 2. Here we go. Ready? 7 minus a minus 3 becomes 7 plus 3. 2 minus a minus 2 becomes 2 plus 2. This is now 10 over 4, which we can reduce. Oh, look at that. To 5 over 2. And that just proves it. We did it. Awesome. So this is a really great way of trying to understand slope, and applying slope is what we're going to do next.